Batting third at shortstop, number 10, Colin Bryan. Batting fourth, the pitcher, number 21, Andrew Smith. Batting fifth, the left fielder, number 7, Daniel Sutterman. Batting sixth, the second baseman, number 17, Ryan Harris. Batting seventh, the third baseman, number 6, Zazan Aniela. Batting eighth, the catcher, number 13, Nikita Lasson. Batting ninth, the right fielder, number 5, David Iron. And batting 10th, designated hitter, number 28, Cesar Hernandez. The coach for America Studies at Lehman College, Nick Vanderpool. And the head coach of the center is Pete Missouri. Your attention, please, ladies and gentlemen. We ask at this time that you please rise and remove your hats for the flying of the National Anthem. Ladies and gentlemen, we have our tonight's championship game. At first base, Steve Batista. At second base, Lane Lansman. At third base, Gary Lasconi. And home plate umpire, Jerome Morales.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Staten Island University Hospital Community Park for the matchup you've been waiting for, the Division A Championship of the PSAL, baseball between Bronx United and the High School for American Studies at Lehman College. You heard it all there from the announcers. Bronx United coming in with a 13-1 record. American Studies coming in undefeated, 14-0 in their season. The one game that Bronx United lost way back at the beginning of April in a 15-12 decision, so not anything to be too upset about. Their offense was there. They just didn't quite have enough on that one, so we are looking at a huge game today. Both of these teams, powerhouses, both from the Bronx, I think. I'm Peter Andrus. I'm bringing you all the action today. Along with me, my trusty co-announcer, Seal. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
All right. We're looking forward to this one. It's going to be a good matchup. They're starting a little bit late. Looks like we've got about a 30-minute delay from when they anticipated, but we are happy to be getting things underway here.
We're not in Kansas anymore. We're not home.
We are the media crew from Abraham Lincoln High School in Brooklyn.
Then how did we end up in Staten?
We've got quite the streaming program, and here we are helping out PSAL, making sure this game gets brought to as many people as possible. Thank you all for watching. Thanks for joining us today. We are here in Staten Island. We mentioned we're at Staten Island University Hospital Community Park. It's a mouthful. I've had to write it down to make sure I don't mess it up. It's home of the Staten Island Ferry Hawks.
Ferry Hawks.
And they were actually just playing a game here before that wrapped up right around 4 o'clock, which is part of the reason for the delay. By the time the teams could clear out the locker rooms and the PSAL teams could then get in and get themselves ready, it was a little bit later than they had hoped. After some warm-ups and some press, we are here, and well, I'll tell you, somebody's about to take the field. We're going to find out.
Oh, the chant has begun.
So taking the field first will be the High School for American Studies. They are in red. They are the Senators.
That's their mascot, Senators?
Yes.
I would say that I've never heard a mascot that. Not common.
Not an animal of some sort.
Yeah, we are the Rail Splitters.
Yeah. Lincoln, we're the Rail Splitters. And of course, we fight quite a few knights, patriots, things of that nature. So Senators shouldn't be all that out of the ordinary, especially for a school called High School for American Studies. And they'll be facing off against the Bronx United Pythons. Coming up first for the Pythons should be Pablo Aquino.
Just watching them rally up, it brings me chills. Feels like a community that I just watch. I watch for fun. I do not at all play the sport. But it's nice. I like the view from here.
Yeah, we have a great view up in one of the press boxes here at the stadium. Want to talk about Bronx United's record real quick. They have been absolutely dominating here late in the season. Some of their playoff games, I'm seeing a 13-0, a 10-0, a 10-0. One closer game at 4-2, but they have been putting up double digits in almost every one of their games coming into this.
Oh,
so
wow.
We're going to be looking for some big offense from the Pythons as Aquino gets ready to come up. You can see him in the next to home plate. Looks like he's getting ready. He's a lefty batter. Right off the bat is not something we always get to see. And he'll be facing off against the arm of number 21. That is Andrew Smith pitching for American Studies.
That was a really fast pitch. It was like the blink of an eye. Certainly not used to that.
Well, don't let the Lincoln coaching staff hear you say that.
They might put a target bomb on my back. Oh, that was a strike.
First strike of the game. We got a 2-1 count.
That's cool.
Hard hit to right. It's over his head. He's running for second. He's rounding third. They're going to send him home. No, they're going to hold him up. And he'll slide down safe at third. Huge leadoff triple to start the game.
You can hear by my voice how shocked I was by that. I was not expecting that. Even after hearing the record. That's a strike.
At bat now is number six. That is Tootie Martinez.
Ooh. Too close to the face.
Swing and a miss. Strike two. And the first run of the game is going to score as the ball gets away.
That's the first out of the game.
Yep, they struck him out. And if you didn't hear our announcer, pitcher Juan Santos coming to the plate.
A little too close, but that is a strike. Another strike. Another struck out.
Second out for Bronx United. You can see exactly why American Studies is here. Pitching that strong will keep you in the playoffs for sure. Josuar Pujols, the shortstop, coming up now. With two outs and nobody on. But one run on the board. Pythons on top. And he swings through strike one. Lays off of that one, 1-1 the count.
Ooh.
That was a strong swing. Just wasn't able to connect it. 2-2 the count now. And he struck him out. So one batter gets up, hits a triple, and makes his way home ultimately at the next at bat. And then three consecutive strikeouts are going to send us to the bottom of the first. One run on the board for the Pythons. Let's see if American Studies has an answer in the bottom of the first. So Python's warming up now.
Oh, they don't want to leave you hanging. Yes, they are.
Juan Santos will be on the mound, number 22, and leading off for the High School for American Studies should be number one, Elijah Slarsky.
Totally off topic, and I know it's not an ad, but one of my parents' companies is on the.
We won't say which one, so we're not showing any favoritism. But
yeah, we're not.
Fun little tidbit to know they're advertising here.
Is that how they make money here?
That is one of the ways. Yes, companies will pay the stadium to put up their ads in the back.
That's cool. That's a strike. Strike two.
That one's outside. Count even at 2-2.
Whoever's doing the graphics is a little bit late.
Swing and a miss, strike three. It's out number one for the High School for American Studies. That brings up number 15, Will Brody.
Does that count as a strike?
Yes, indeed it does.
Oh.
1-2, the count.
Oh.
Hard hit. It's foul, and it's going to go into the stands. Count still 1-2.
As long as it's in the green, does it count?
In between the two white lines on.
Oh.
Yeah, fair ball has to be between those white lines. Foul balls are outside of it. They can catch them until they go to the stands. Brody lays off, gains himself another ball.
That's another one. Ooh. That was pretty close to a family.
Swing and a miss, strike three. Not a bad at bat, just not a great result for Brody. But he did try to up that pitch count and get a little bit under Santos's skin, letting him know they can hit off him. Just got to get it in the right direction. Darwin Bryan now. 1-0. Make that 1-1. They got him. That's strike three, out three. No runs for American Studies. And we move to the top of the second.
Already?
First pitch, strike. Ooh, that one bounced off the roof right above us.
We were saved, it almost hit us. That's the first out.
Three pitches, three strikes. I didn't even get to announce that that was Justin Dieza, right fielder. And that brings up third baseman Luis Beltran. Saw the ump just turned around waving the 3-1 count. The scoreboard in the back was still showing 2-1. And that's going to be the first walk of the game. Beltran gets to base on balls. That one back. full count now to Luis Beltran. Excuse me, to Batista. Beltran is on first, and he goes. They'll try to pick him off, but he's going to get there easily.
This is the second out for the Pythons, correct?
Yes, that on that play, the second out happened. As Batista struck out, Beltran advanced to second. And now catcher Carlos Solomon will try to advance him to third. Inside ball two. Fouls that one off. 2-1 the count. Beltran taking his lead at second. And that one's fouled back. Count even. Back again. Still 2-2. Swing and a miss. Strike three. And that'll end the inning. The Pythons strand one. They still lead 1-0 as we move to the bottom of the second.
Your weekend, Mr. Ray?
It's going great now that the skies are starting to clear a little bit. Air is a little easier to breathe.
Kind of looked a little bit like doomsday the other day.
Any of you who aren't in the tri-state area, we had a very dark orange Wednesday evening. And leading into Thursday, New York City schools went remote for 2 days. They were already 2 days that students would not be in session in middle schools and elementary schools, so it was only a switch for the high schoolers on Friday, really.
Yep.
Oh, as a teacher, I can tell you it was a nice little break to have.
As a student, I can tell you that it was awesome. I got a free day to go to sleep. All I had to do was say I'm present, do a couple of classwork, and I was good for the day. It was a very easy day.
Don't let the school chancellor hear you say that. They'd like to know you were working a little harder than that.
Trust me, I work hard. I'm a straight A student.
Andrew Smith coming up for American Studies.
You? Do you play? Andrew Smith?
Andrew Smith, the pitcher. Ooh, look at that freighter coming along the back. This is a beautiful view behind this ballpark. gets him on the outside corner. Strike one. I was about to think that was a little outside, but we're going to decide the ump has a better view than I do. That one was right over the plate, but did not have the right height. 1-1. Swing and a miss, strike two. And he hits that to the outfield. Right fielder is there.
That's an out?
That is an out. Tremendous catch by the right fielder. That should be Justin Deza. And that's the first ball put in play for the High School for American Studies. They had three strikeouts to start the game. And that's strike one coming to Daniel Schneiderman. And it's a three-pitch strikeout, two away. Brings up Ryan Harris. Lefty batter on strike one. Make it strike two. Fouls that off to keep himself alive. He was out in front of it.
To keep himself alive and the crowd over here. A couple of people jumped.
There's a hard hit into right. Right fielder's getting under it. Manages not to lose it in the sun. And that's three up, three down for the second inning here in Staten Island.
Their score may be 1-0, but I would say that the Pythons' defense is pretty good.
This is definitely a pitcher's duel so far today.
A pitcher's duel?
Pitcher's duel meaning that the pitcher is doing most of the work. The teams have not had too much to do, with the exception of the right fielder for the Pythons. And with the exception of the leadoff hit for the Pythons, there really has been no action. And a combined 10 strikeouts out of 12 total outs. Four strikeouts coming for Juan Santos, the pitcher from Bronx United. And six strikeouts coming off the arm of Andrew Smith for the High School for American Studies. Look, That's two quick strikes thrown. Make it three. And Python's already down one. That brings up Pablo Aquino. The only hit of the game with the leadoff triple. The only run of the game as he stole on a wild pitch at the next at bat. And there's another base hit. Aquino going for second. He's rounding. They'll throw it in for a cutoff. And they're sending him home. And he'll make it easily. Inside the park home run for Pablo Aquino.
I've only seen him bat twice, but I don't expect less from him anymore.
At Abraham Lincoln High School, the baseball diamond is on the football field. So in the park, home runs happen when you hit it into deep left because you've got 100 yards for that ball to run. But here in an actual ballpark, seeing something like that is just special. And there is a strike to Judy Martinez. Hits it over to first. It bounces off his glove. The play will be not in time. They call him safe at first.
We have people jumping up and down in the stands now.
That's going to be a close call. Popular on half the fans and unpopular to the other half.
Nope, the other half is sitting pretty quiet.
Suddenly, Bronx United really waking up with their bats. Runner goes, and the ball is actually going to get out of the hands of the catcher. Now you've got Martinez safe on second. Santos takes ball two. Runner goes, and it's a hit over to second. And the throw is going to miss. That's going to bring in the third run. Pythons have really woken up this inning.
Yes, they have. I wish there was a saying to go along with pythons and waking. I don't know, like, pythons have come out of their cave, or I don't know. There's not really a saying. But the energy is there. It's now there.
Think you could go with the Pythons are striking.
We can say that. Ooh.
Ooh, big swing.
And you see the anger on the at the batter.
1-2 the count.
The one thing I can say that I admire from this game is that both crowds from both parties are ecstatic.
Yeah, a lot of good energy in the stadium today. Everybody very happy to be here, very happy to see who is going to be crowned the champion of A Division Baseball.
Whoa.
Big hard hit foul down the left field line.
Yeah.
Count stays at 1-2. Guarantee you Santos sat back at second, was hoping that was going to stay fair. He was ready to run. As he runs there and steals third for himself. Great position for the Pythons to be in. One out and a man on third, and there's a chopper down the third baseline. The play at the plate is
safe.
The play was on time, but he dropped the ball. The run scores.
And once again, the crowd is ecstatic. Is it ecstatic or S?
Ecstatic.
Ecstatic.
Pujols is going to score and get to first on a fielder's choice. Santos is going to score. He did perfectly to run into the catcher and disrupt the ball, knocked it out of his glove, and so he is safe. The score is 4-0.
Ooh.
Here in Staten Island.
You see the crowd getting upset at the first baseman.
Swing and a miss.
Ooh. Ooh.
That throw was not on target. There was no way they were stopping him.
I kind of chuckled on the fact that he was running to second and he slid on the base. And so he fell off it.
I think he was looking at the ball and not where he was going. Now he's stealing third and he's in time.
I feel like they're taking a lot more risks. Or they're taking more opportunities.
It's aggressive base running, to be sure, but that's part of how you get your high-scoring games in this league. You make sure that your opponent's defense is up to the task. And so far, High School for American Studies has not found an answer today.
The ump right now is waving the count. So the people doing the 3-1 or 2-1?
I believe it's 2-1.
Okay. Ooh.
Swing and a miss, it's 2-2.
Oh, I think he got confused.
Oh. Maybe it was two. Oh, yeah, he did get confused. So did the graphics person that cleared the graphics off. They brought it back. And hard hit to center. It is caught for the second out of the inning. No, it is the third out.
You sure?
No? No, I'm not sure.
Kind of says one out right now.
I only have one out here, too.
It also seems that, like, both teams are confused.
Yeah, they're sending the runner back to third for the Python, saying...
two. They're all waving at two.
Yeah, that should only have been the second out. I'm looking at my scorecard here. I had a strikeout to start the inning from Ishmael Izbarra.
If you see.
And that was the only out so far.
If you see the.
And now they're telling the Python, you've touched the bag, come back and hit it. That should be a tagged up run for him. I'm curious to see which way this goes.
Well, both sides are saying that it was a second out. And the umps are now calling. Yep. It's confirmed. It was just two outs.
Yep, that was only two outs. I'm guessing that tagged up run is going to count. I've put it on my scoreboard, but it has not been added officially to the scoreboard here yet.
For two outs?
For the run to count.
Oh.
I've got the two outs.
Who has the mock trial team? Bring them up.
Oh, they're bringing the scoreboard up to show the umps. Which runners have gone and what's happened, because they collectively think that there must have been three. I suppose it wouldn't be it wouldn't be high school baseball if we didn't have a moment like this. Now when we get the scoreboard coming, run the scorekeeper coming from American Studies.
We have a couple of parents saying there's four umps.
They haven't asked me for the video review yet.
We're still here.
It would be nice if they did, but.
Oh.
And okay, the umpires have told the coaches to get lost, and they will now discuss what happened so far in this inning.
Like we said, we are here for video review.
For any of you that are just joining us, we have it as the number nine batter came up, Ishmael Izbarra, and it was a strikeout. Pablo Aquino came up and home runned in the park. Tuti Martinez singled. Juan Santos reached after a bad throw at first. And that scored Martinez. And then Pujols reached on a fielder's choice as Santos made his way home, and he didn't get called out at home. He got called safe. I think that might be where the confusion came in. If he had been called out, that would have been the second out, but he was called safe, which is why the score was 4-0 to begin with.
Now both, which you mean, see that both both coaches are just anxiously walking around them. Yeah.
So Dieza flying out to center field should only be the second out of the inning. I hope they figure this out and get it right, because we have the video here. And if it goes wrong, fans will not hesitate to let them know and show them this video to show them that it went this way.
Use us, we are video. Like you said, this wouldn't be high school baseball if this didn't happen.
Any of you who are fans of high school baseball, or really for that matter, any of the high school sports, at some point there's always some little confusion out there between the umpires, the referees, and the coaches and teams.
You hear the patience going low on these people now.
The crowd starting to get a little involved. They know what they saw.
And now the manager is involved?
At this level, the manager and coach are the same person.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, you mean the team manager, the student manager?
The student
sure.
manager.
Yeah.
It looks like they're having a council meeting now. The umpires are trying to explain something.
Now, will they?
Yeah, I think they favored.
All right. It looks like they're sending the runner back to third. So that will bring our score back to 4-0. They'll say he's not tagging up. So I will change my score line on our YouTube graphic there. Sorry to give the Bronx United fans so much hope. So Pujols back on third base, waiting to come home and wishing he had been given the opportunity to tag up. But right now, the High School for American Studies is not yet back on the field. Now, the umpires are motioning for them to get back on the field.
But as you see, the umpire and the coaches are having a heated discussion.
So the umpires have made the right call that it was only the second out. They are calling American Studies back onto the field. And honestly, in my opinion, it's the right call to not count the tagged up run because of the confusion and then everybody going in at the moment. So the call is correct. Somebody just has to convince the coaches for American Studies. And they've gone back to their dugout, so they are, in fact, convinced. We're getting back underway. Coming up should be number 77, Luis Beltran. And he is, in fact, standing in the on-deck space just outside a home plate, waiting for a couple of warm-up pitches to come in. Really, I think all that confusion came from the play at home plate where the ball made it in time, but the catcher dropped it on the collision. Because that scored in your scorebooks as a fielder's choice, which many people would automatically look at and think that was an out in your scorebook. All right, a couple of practice pitches there. Andrew Smith. I'm sorry, pitching is Brody. I didn't even realize they had made a pitching change at some point. William Brody is now on the mound. Here's a big argument between the umpire and the coach. And they've sent him off.
When coaches are sent off, what does that mean?
He'll have to go to the locker room, and he will not be allowed back out on the field. It's just a shame that this has to happen now. At this point, everybody just wants the game to get back underway. The players are ready to go. Throws a strike.
I guess you can say that playoff games do get heated.
They do indeed.
Never seen that before.
And there's just a little blooper towards first. They'll make the throw and the play for the third out, so the run does not count. 4-0 the score. After 2.5 innings, we move to the bottom of the third.
So I'm guessing that coach just took his bag and left. Went home.
Oh, he's not going to go home. He'll be in the locker room. He will still want to be able to talk to his players. If American Studies can come back, he will definitely want to be here to celebrate with his players. But he needed to communicate somehow that he had felt slighted, did not like the way things were going.
Is it possible for all coaches in one team to get sent out?
Yes. But usually you'll have at least one person who just keep themselves seated on the bench and just wait things out, because you've got to have somebody there. Beautiful shot of the Statue of Liberty, which is visible in the outfield. Not sure if you can see it when you get back to the wide shot, but it is there, just in center field.
Leading off the center, third baseman number 6 is Alvarado.
Outside, 2-2 to his Adanita. Full count. Swing and a miss. Strike three. One away. Is Nikita Lexanov at the bat now? 0-2 the count. And they strike him out. Designated hitter Cesar Hernandez coming up to the plate. Another lefty on the squad. Nice to hear some positive chanting from the crowd. Let's go, Caesar. Nice to hear the crowd getting back into this after the disruption earlier in the inning. Up and three down, all on strikeouts. Great inning for the Pythons. We go to the top of the fourth. Bronx United up by four. Just heard the announcer. They just announced the games for tomorrow, the AA and AAA baseball games. They were scheduled for 3-7. They're now scheduled for 12-3. They both got pushed up by 3 hours. We should be bringing you those games right here on Lincoln Media. So please hit that subscribe button and stick with us. We appreciate your support. Always happy to bring you the sports action around New York City, especially from our home field in Coney Island. But also as much as the PSAL can get us to stream. This is Batista with a 1-2 count now. And they strike him out. Carlos Solomon, the catcher, steps up, and that one is going to get away. 1-0. Strike two. One's low. It's, I think, the second walk of the game.
The left fielder, number 8, Ishmael Izmaro.
First walk of the game was to Beltran back in the second. Now Ishmael Izmaro will come up. He started the last inning with a strikeout. He was one of the only outs we were sure about. Runner goes, and the play will not be in time. He's standing by the time that ball gets there. Runner goes to third, and he is there in time. There in plenty of time. One thing we've seen the Pythons do extremely well today is steal their way around the bases. There have not been that many base runners, but when they've had them, they have moved themselves with ease. Called strike, full count. Swing and a miss, strike three. And just so we're all clear, that is the second out of the inning.
I think he was walked.
Look at that. That is not the second out of the inning. It's another walk. My mistake. And he steals second. He did it before the pitch even went. And of course, at bat now, Pablo Aquino. The one batter you don't want to see. Oh, I'm sorry, that's Tuti Martinez. Okay, nope, what happened, Seal? They did an intentional walk to Aquino.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so there are two outs. That's what happened. It was a strike three. He was out, and then rather than face Aquino, who has a triple and a home run today,
yeah,
they just let him go to first. And that is why Tuti Martinez is now at the plate with an 0-2 count.
Oh.
And it's hit high to right. It was caught. And that's how this one's going to end. Bronx United strands two. High School for American Studies able to prevent any further damage as we move to the bottom of the fourth. They trail by four. They're going to try to put some runs on with top of the lineup coming up. That's Elijah Slarsky.
The music choice is quite a mix. In the beginning of the game, there was country music, and now I don't know what this type of music is, pop. I would say it's pop. Do the schools have to send in their graphics so it can be done?
The schools do send in a logo to PSAL, and in this case, PSAL sent those logos to me. Very often when we're making graphics for our regular season games, I have to go to Google and hope I pick the right logo for a team. Some of the teams we know better than others, like our, especially in our basketball season, we always know the right logos to use.
Yep.
With South Brooklyn basketball, some of the best in the city.
Yeah.
So those are always big name teams to have.
I'd say it's pretty cool you're playing high school baseball and yet you've made it to a stadium.
That's it. We're playing in a professional ballpark right now. Not to take anything away from this, but tomorrow's two games at Yankee Stadium. That's
Yankee
a
Stadium.
Memory to take away. You may never play ball in college, you may never play professionally, but you can always know that you played at Yankee Stadium.
In high school.
In high school. Three pitches, three strikes. Slarsky goes down looking. Will Brody coming up to bat. Brody, now the pitcher, originally the first baseman. And I'm pretty sure they're going to say he went on that 0-1. miss. Strike three. That is the ninth strikeout.
In the game or for the team?
Just for Juan Santos, the pitcher for
nine?
The Pythons. Nine strikeouts. That's nine of the 11 outs that American Studies has gotten so far. Come on, strikeouts.
Mr. A, have you ever been in a cruise before?
I have. Those of you wondering why Seal's bringing that up, there is a cruise ship floating just by the flagpoles in deep center field.
Talking about
and there's a hit
field.
To the outfield. I hope you were looking at that cruise ship. The ball went right for it as it's a double. First hit of the game for American Studies.
Well, their crowd is now amplified.
Well, now I can say it. He just broke up a perfect game. For Santos. That was Darwin Bryan with the hit. Brings up Andrew Smith, who hits to the same place, and it's going to drop in. You know Brian's coming around. One run scores. They're going to wave him around second. And they will hold him there. And finally, American Studies gets themselves on the board. Takes one back, it's 4-1. Off the RBI triple from Andrew Smith. And that brings up Daniel Schneiderman. Fouls one off 0-1.
Coach certainly doesn't look too happy with that swing.
Schneiderman, three pitches, three strikes. And that's how this inning's going to end. But American Studies gets one back. They trail by three as we move to the top of the fifth. Coming up for the Pythons should be Santos, Pujols, and Dieza.
Went to really big cruise. Going back to the cruise.
Yeah, now would be the time to talk about the cruise. Now that the baseball game is in a break.
I don't think I've been on one, have I?
I wouldn't know, but certainly you haven't been on one recently if you're asking that question.
Probably,
I think
yeah.
You would remember. It looks like a Norwegian cruise. I think I see an NCL lettering on the top there.
You have better eyesight than I do, and I'm the one who has glasses.
Well, look in your viewfinder. The ship is leaving the screen. There you go.
It goes... Oh, look, there we go. It says, yeah, Norwegian
Joy. The Norwegian Joy. That's one of their larger ships. Okay, maybe I know a little bit about cruises. I always like cruises to the Caribbean that leave out of New York because you get a couple of days down, a couple of days back at sea. So you can just relax on the boat, take advantage of the amenities.
Look, they have slides. Like, I've seen them on ads, but I've, like,
never got to really see the boat up close.
Yeah.
Beautiful view of the river here.
You know what's also a beautiful view? The game.
Yep. And here it is, Santos coming up to bat. Top of the fifth inning, 4-1 Bronx United. That's hit over to third, the throw, no problem there. Outside ball one. Just for Pujols, swing and a miss. Connects one of those, he is gonna smack it.
Really?
You've got a very strong swing.
So strong, he loses his own balance.
There it goes, and it's gonna drop for a base hit. So Pujols finally gets his first official hit of the game, second time reaching. Brings up Justin Dieza, 0 for 2. Runner goes to second on the wild pitch. Now he's going for third, and they got him. Said before what a great job the Pythons have been doing at moving themselves around the infield, stealing bases, and American Studies hadn't found an answer for it, but they did now.
Looks like the ball hit his foot. You see how in tennis there's like ball boys or ball girls? In baseball, is there the same thing?
Ooh. There's a hit. And mishandled by the outfielder, but it won't make a difference. It's a stand-up single.
Third baseman, number 77, Louis Beltran.
Goes inside and ends up hitting Beltran. He's going to get his base on the hit by pitch.
Center fielder number 45, Julio Bautista.
little pop up in the direction of third, and it is caught for the third out of the inning. Nice job there by the third baseman to make that catch.
Now back to my question. You see how in tennis there's like ball boys and ball girls? Is there like an equivalent in baseball?
There are usually ball boys in professional leagues. They're usually family members of the team somehow. People that know the coaching staff, you know, children or cousins or something like that. And their job would be to run out extra balls to the umpires for them to give to the catchers to throw in.
Not bad. Do you know if they get paid?
I don't know.
I'll become someone else's family member. And if I get paid to, you know, give the ump some balls, then I'm okay with that. That'll be my summer job. Talking about summer job, I recently found out that I could apply for a comic book shop. And I did not know. And I really want to do that. And I got
Sounds
me a
like
Joker.
A fun way to spend a summer.
I got myself a Joker comic book. It's pretty good. It's very dark, but it's really good.
On the mound now for the Pythons, still number 22, Juan Santos. Leading off for American Studies will be Ryan Harris. Harris with a big hit, shallow center, it is caught. Zadanita. Takes ball one. Outside corner, just barely. Usually on a 3-0, you get it right down the center. Way outside, Anita gets the first walk for High School for American Studies. First pitch strike to Nikita. It's inside. It's going to get away from the catcher. The runner is going to make his way to second.
That's another out.
Indeed it is. Two outs. Full count, 3-2, two outs. Now a meeting on the mound, maybe just to break it up a little bit. Him out. So High School for American Studies tries to get something together, put a little rally up. Nothing doing. Python shut him down. We're moving to the top of the sixth. 4-1 here in Staten Island. Beautiful day here at the ballpark. Visibility in the distance a bit low. So we still have some haze hanging in the air from the Canada wildfires that really darkened the city at the end of last week. Ooh, he thought he had a walk. It is 2-2. Fouls that one off. This is Carlos Solomon, the catcher. And that fouls that one straight back, almost above us. Still pitching for American Studies is number 15, Will Brody. Swing and a miss, strike three. He is not happy about that. Hitting number 19, that's Jariel Diaz, who just came in for Ismael Ezbarra, I guess.
Now everyone's going happy about this one.
Aquino stepping up. They intentionally walked him before. And they do again.
What?
A triple and an in-the-park home run, his first two at-bats, and they're just not going to deal with him.
How does that work?
Which part?
I don't remember.
The intentional walk?
Yeah, I don't remember seeing them hit him.
They didn't hit the man on first. They hit the guy who's on second now. And he went to first. And then the next batter was Pablo Aquino, who you remember the last time when we thought it was a strikeout and then we thought it was a walk. It's an intentional walk. Rather than pitch to him, they just let him take the base.
Wait, really? They just...
Yeah, rather than deal with him potentially having another huge hit, they just let him go on base.
So it's like a free walk?
Yes. In professional baseball, they'll still make you throw the four pitches. Hmm. But at the high school level...
Ooh!
Oh, pickoff play, they beam him in the head. Obviously by accident, we hope he's okay. They're checking on him. Definitely a painful thing to have happen, but he looks like he's all right, just shaking up a little bit. Just an unfortunate thing, the way the pickoff play works at second, you end up throwing to a running shortstop who's going to try to make that tag, and the ball ended up just bouncing off, I think, his helmet. I hope it didn't get him. But he is up, so probably the helmet. Happy to see he's okay. Late start, runners go, and they make it. Martinez showed bunt, which kind of distracted the infield. Smart play by the Pythons. And now Tootie hit a little base hit blooper. One run will score, and of course Aquino's coming around. There will be no play at the plate. He'll slide in easily.
You can see how everyone's happy, jumping up and down.
Python's crowd is energized as they pull ahead 6-1.
And
here's another
one
popped up to center. He's going back underneath it, makes the catch. Runner tags. They'll try to make the play over at third. Not in time. That was Santos with the sacrifice fly to advance the runner. And that brings up number 32, Josuar Pujols. Pujols singled his last at bat. Ooh. Swing and a miss, strike one here. Popped up to left. Third baseman's underneath it, makes the catch for the third out of the inning, but the damage done. Bronx United tacks on another two. The score now 6-1. Stick around when the game is over. We will bring you the presentation of the championship banner to whichever team comes out on top. Like to thank PSAL for inviting us to bring this game to you. We always enjoy bringing a good PSAL championship game live to you on YouTube. And of course, thank you to Staten Island University Hospital Community Park for hosting this matchup of the A Division Finals for the 2023 season. Thank you. And it's a drop strike three. He'll run.
So if the batter, if the catcher drops the ball at strike three, he can run?
Yes.
Okay.
Which is something we saw quite a bit when we were streaming softball this season.
Yeah.
On both sides of it. Dropped strike threes as the catchers often struggle to get that ball. And it's a caught foul.
Caught foul means that it's out,
that's
right?
That's an out, correct.
Look at me learning things. Took me a whole season.
This is Darwin Bryant. Darwin Bryant had a double his first last at bat. And the play is made at second for the second out of the inning. Ryan reaches on the fielder's choice. That'll bring up Andrew Smith. He was the starting pitcher. Now he is the third baseman for High School for American Studies. He'll take ball one. It's outside. It gets away, and that'll advance the runner. Make the pickoff play, and it's going to roll out into the outfield. And so Brian's going to make his way to third. So a meeting of the minds on the mound right now. The crowd chanting, let him stay. Smith awaits the 1-0. It's outside, but he swings 1-1. Little chopper back up at the pitcher, and he misses it. And a run will score. And it's 6-2. And that'll bring up Daniel Schneiderman. Schneiderman 0 for 2 today. And they are going to pinch run, bring in Miles Green.
Pinch running at first base number 4, Miles Green.
Hard hit, pop up in the direction of left. Shortstop tries to get underneath it and he misses. Ryan Harris coming up to bat, and they're going to have another little meeting at the mound. As finally, High School for American Studies seems to have dialed in on Juan Santos. Will they leave him with the ball to fight through this? Lead by four, but they've still got four outs they need to earn before they can call this game theirs. And not sure what the debate is between umpire and manager for the Pythons.
We heard booing from. Yeah,
the crowd is definitely not happy to be waiting for some decision. Right now, the umpire and the coach for Bronx United are talking to a PSAL official. Came over from American Studies, but they're not getting involved after one of them has already been ejected. I don't know the coaching staff well enough to know if it was a head coach or an assistant, but one is already down, so
they're not the other one.
They're not about to push their luck with anyone else.
I wonder what the talk is about.
You and me both. Guessing there's some sort of a procedural issue. So the coach is now left. Now it's just the umpire talking to a PSAL official. We are not sure what the issue is. What we do know is that the score is 6-2 in the bottom of the sixth. Two outs, runners on the corners. And the Python squad is waiting patiently. Most of them are on the pitcher's mound. We have a second PSAL official now in on the action, but still no explanation to the crowd.
I wonder what the other coach was yelling about. Now there's people from I forgot the other side. Not American.
The Pythons.
Pythons. They're just pointing to the scoreboard.
Oh, the discussions may be over. They're coming back. We're going to talk about it some more. I swear, folks, they're going to explain something to us. I can't actually promise that. They might tell us nothing and just get right back on with the game.
And we may never know.
High school baseball, here we are.
In action.
It's a great time to remind you that once again tomorrow the championships will be played at Yankee Stadium at 12 noon and 3 p.m. We'll definitely be bringing you that second game, waiting on confirmation that we'll be available to get you the first. 12 noon, right in the middle of my teaching day.
And my learning day. I wonder what class I have at 12.
It might be my class.
It may be more likely your class.
All right, the meeting of the minds seems to have ended. Now they got to come out and explain it to the team, whatever happened. Hopefully they explain it to the in-stadium announcer, and hopefully he explains it to us. Otherwise, we've wasted about 10 minutes of your time and we'll never explain to you why. Sorry, folks at home. So here we go, two outs, runners on the corners. It does seem we're going to get back underway, but I'm still not sure what the procedural issue we were all debating there was.
Don't know, but the coach of the Pythons looks extremely happy. He's smiling and talking to the assistant coach and waving the number two.
Can you get me a shot of that? I don't know.
Where are they? They're right there.
Runner goes, they choose not to make a play to make sure that the run couldn't come home. Hit into left, it's foul if they drop it. And they do, 1-1 the count. Miles Green running from third and Daniel Schneiderman running from second. And that's going to drop in for a base hit. It's going to score two runs. And they missed the play at second. And if he had gotten up quicker, he might have been able to get it all the way over to third. But just like that, it is just a two-run ball game.
Hold on, something looks up. The runner on second looks injured.
I don't think he had any collisions with anyone, but he may have slid into the bag.
Something with his throat.
That would be why he wasn't as quick as we expected him to be to get up after the overthrow at second. That is Ryan Harris at second. And he is up. Harris will steal easily. The count now to Uzada Nita. Nope. I am mistaken. They struck him out. And that's the way this inning is going to end. Now we move to the top of the seventh. Bronx United up by only two. Friendly announcement in the park to not rush the field at the end of the game. Freedom Tower in the distance. We've mentioned the haze hanging low on the city. Beautiful reflection from the sunset happening just right now. Justin Dieza leading off. He'll take ball one. Crowd booing as Justin Dieza goes to get some quick batting advice from his coach.
Every time the Senators boo, the Pythons always ask for a scoreboard check.
Himself a walk. Beltran hit by pitch his last time up. Had a walk his first time. I believe that one was fouled off, so the runner will go back. This time the runner goes, and he'll make it. Oh, they call him out. Believe there was obstruction from the base runner. Obstruction on the batter. So the steal is no good.
Obstruction on the batter.
Yeah, the batter stood in the way of the catcher trying to make the throw.
Oh.
So by standing in his way, the steal does not count. In fact, that runner is out. And the batter was out as well.
What?
I believe he struck out.
Is that a field number 45, Julio Batista?
Julio Batista, 0 for 3 today. He got just a little piece of that. So it's a foul, keeps himself alive. And that one's gonna fly right into him. And so Batista gets on for the first time today. And the pickoff play at first is good. They got him. He can't believe it, but they got him. And that's how the top of the seventh will go for the Pythons. Arguably one of their worst innings of the day. They just have to hold it together now defensively for three outs. And this game is theirs. But make no mistake about it, High School for American Studies is chomping at their heels. The Senators are down two, but they woke up in the sixth inning, and they are hoping to make some more magic here. All right, all this time in Staten Island, we hadn't seen the ferry until right now.
Now, this one I do remember going on multiple times. I'm right here trying to race the ferry. It leaves the screen and I have to skip it.
No worries, I'm going back to the game now anyway.
Are you saying my shot isn't good enough? That's crazy.
Oh, your shot was fantastic. It's just you should have moved with the ferry instead of letting it travel across the screen.
But it looks cool like that.
Seven. This should be the last inning unless they score two and then get out, in which case we'll go to extras. Strike one.
So what I'm listening is that they have to
they got to score two to stay in it.
Uh-huh.
They got to score three to win it.
And then what about the Pythons?
Pythons, it's just have to play defense right now. Popped up, it's foul, and it'll be out of play. If the Pythons can get these three outs without letting in two runs, they win. But if they let two runs score, we're definitely going to another inning. Yeah, if they let three runs score, they lose. And there's a base hit to start the rally.
I would say that this is where the real battle begins.
American Study is not going quietly into the night. I think they just said they pinch ran the runner with Noah Connolly, number 11. Coming up now is Cesar Hernandez. Quick meeting of the umpires. Swing and a miss, strike two to Hernandez. Strike three. That's three strikeouts on the day for Cesar Hernandez. And now Bronx United is two outs away from victory. Leadoff batter Elijah Slarsky. Top of the lineup, rather. Battling his way back. It was down 3-0. It's now 3-2. Popped up towards second. It's going to drop for a base hit. And the throw is just a little high. The runner is safe. Pulled the fielder's foot off the bag, having to jump to make the catch. And that's all they needed. And now it's two on. And now they'll come out to have another talk with Santos. Debate whether or not he is going to get a complete game out of this. Pitched 6 1/3. Got players down on the sideline pumping up American Studies right now. Coming in to pitch.
A crowd favorite.
The player, he only got to bat twice, and then they've intentionally walked him every other time. So definitely the offensive powerhouse for the Pythons today. And now their closer. Bring him in to get two outs and give this team a championship. That's what their coach is thinking.
Ooh. By the looks of it, his throws are pretty hard.
is Will Brody at the bat. And Brody will take, I think that's ball three. My graphic is one behind. Here we are, 3-0. And they're gonna walk him. Bases loaded, one out for American Studies. Darwin Bryan coming up. Bryan's put the ball in play his last two at bats. And of course, the Pythons all coming in to come hype their guy up. Bases loaded, one out. They cannot afford to let in three runs. Three runs and this is over, and not the way they want it. The strike zone that time, 1-1 the count. American Studies trying to get the crowd to hype up, 2-1. They have a one out rally here in the bottom of the seventh. Count even, 2-2. Darwin Bryan at the plate. Fouls that one back, stays alive. Aquino on the mound, trying to close out.
That was very close.
Outside, full count. Bryan's got to be expecting something right over the strike zone now. They don't want to walk a run in. And he'll foul it off to keep the at-bat going.
There's a lot of tension.
This is playoff baseball at its finest, folks. He hits it into play to short. They make the throw home. The force play is on. One more out. Two outs, bases loaded. Andrew Smith will come up. Swings through, strike one. Smith is 2-for-1 today. A single and a triple, two RBIs, one on each of those hits. Can he get another RBI here? Swing and a miss, strike two. American Studies down to their final strike. But one swing for a base hit could send us to more innings. There's a chopper to short. He wanted to make the throw to second. And it's a play, pick, a rundown. They make it with the rundown. They get the out. They get the victory. The Pythons are your Division A PSAL champions. The bases were loaded. The shortstop made a catch. The second baseman didn't get on the bag when the shortstop looked to throw. There was no one there for him. The run scored at home. But then another base runner tried to get in and he did not make it. They got him in a play at the plate. That's the final out, and that's the way this one will end. Bronx United on top by one run, 6-5. As the teams line up to shake hands one last time for the season. Stick with us here. We will bring you the presentation. I believe all the players get a medal, but one team gets the trophy and gets the banner to forever hang in their field or gymnasium. Of course, the ceremonial Gatorade over the coach's head.
Team William Brody. Number 7, Marcos Fernandez. Number 16, Justin Garcia. Number 8, Ishmael Isbara. Number 34, Emmanuel Martinez. Number 6, Tuti Martinez. Number 27, Enrique Perez. Number 32, Jasmar Pujols. Number 9, Victor Rodriguez. Number 13, Carlos Solomon. And number 22, Juan Santos. Accepting the 2023 City Championship Team Trophy is Python's head coach, Joshua Kirchin.
Congratulations to the Bronx United Pythons, your 2023 A Division champions. Posing for one last photo. We can't see any better than you can, but this is usually where they have the banner in front of them.
and gentlemen, the Public School Athletic League would like to once again thank the Staten Island Berry Hawks and Staten Island University Hospital Community Park for hosting the 2023 PSAL Daily Division Championships. And we invite you here to Hawk City next Tuesday, June 20th, and it will take on Long Island at 6:30. Ladies and gentlemen, Public School Athletic League, Bronx United, the School for American Studies and Lehman College, Staten Island Berry Hawks, and Staten Island University Hospital Community Park, thank you for attending today's championship game. Safe home and good night.
That's going to do it for us here in Staten Island. Thanks, everybody, for watching, joining, subscribing. Tomorrow's games, the AA and AAA championships being played at noon and immediately following, probably 3 o'clock, at Yankee Stadium. We will be bringing you both of those games. I have gotten confirmation. Seal is happy. We will be traveling to Yankee Stadium. So to all you students out there, try not to get caught watching our live stream in class, but, you know, make sure you still subscribe and all that good stuff. And to everybody else, thanks for watching. We've really had a great time. For Seal Mancebo, I'm Peter Andrus, and everybody here at Lincoln Media, thank you very much. Thank you to the PSAL, and thank you, of course, to Staten Island University Hospital for letting us use their beautiful stadium here. We will see you next time.